Hello people, welcome to the Gamers of Nations. I'm Ben, and I'm here with a very special unboxing. Now it's not a game this time, in fact it's two Blu-ray sets. Why am I unboxing Blu-rays, you might ask? Well, they link in very much with a series that is going to happen later on this as well, very soon. And they're also the reason why I do these videos now. Because they inspired me into what I want to go and do later on in life. So, let's get to it. What I'm going to be unboxing today is the Red vs. Blue X Seasons 1 to 10 Blu-ray box set. I'm also going to be unboxing Season 11, but this is going to take up the majority of the video. So, for those of you who don't know what Red vs. Blue is, it is the most popular web show on the face of the planet, and I'm not actually lying when I say that. It is the most popular web show on the face of the planet. It is the first web series that successfully used machinima techniques, where you film from inside a game world. So this was used like they filmed in Halo. All of it is in-game, sort of. They act in the game. It's kind of difficult to explain. You understand what machinima is, it's been around long enough. I'm not on about the YouTube channel machinima here, I'm on about the film style machinima. It started in 2003, and it was the first thing Rooster Teeth Productions ever did. Now, if you watch the videos, if you watch Games of Nations a lot, and maybe even Games of Plato when I was still doing it, you would often hear me talk about Achievement Hunter and Rooster Teeth and how much I love them. And it's because of this that I love these guys. And this was the first thing they did, and it was the thing that catapulted them into the limelight. It was directed by Bernie Burns, who is the creator of Rooster Teeth, and then later directed by Gavin Free, who is a very big role model to me. I think Gavin is amazing. He's someone I look up to. Matt Hallam, and then Miles Luna, who recently did Season 11. So let's get into unboxing RvBX. So this is Seasons 1 to 10, 2003 to 2013. Of Red vs. Blue, and it also contains Grifball Volumes 1 and 2, Blood Gulch Chronicles bonus content, so that's Season 1 5 bonus content, and behind the scenes of Red vs. Blue. Grifball Volumes 1 and 2, it's kind of like a mini series based around the game type Grifball, which Gavin Free created. You can go and play that from Halo. He and Jeff Ramsey from Achievement Hunter made Grifball, and then it got picked up by Bungie and they put it in the actual game. Just a nice bit of trivia there for you. So you open it up and inside you can see three Halo soldiers. On this side you have Sarge, this side you have Church, and then in the middle, if you can see it, try and get it in the light, you have Tess. So of course Church, blue guy, is from Blue Army, he's the leader of the Blue Army. Sarge, red guy, leader of the Red Army. And Tex, in the middle, is a freelancer. Seasons 1 to 5 focus a lot around the Reds and the Blues. You have a few freelancers in there. Their concept is kind of introduced during Seasons 1 to 5, but not really explored a lot. Season 1 to 5 is one big storyline. Then you have Seasons 6, 7 and 8, which are their own storyline. And then you have Seasons 9 and 10, which focus very much around the Project Freelancer aspect. So you get a lot more tech, a lot more freelancers and stuff like that in Seasons 9 and 10. Season 11 then starts its own new storyline again. It does get quite complicated towards the end of Season 5, and then 6, 7 and 8 are also quite complicated at times, but yeah, it's fun. On the inside you have this little booklet which explains it's written by some of the people who have been with Red vs Blue since the beginning and about their experiences over 10 years. And on the back it's signed by everybody at RvB. So yeah. Then you open up the flap and inside you have a lot of displays. So I won't really be able to show you all of them, but I can kind of try. So over here you've got disc 1 and 2, which is seasons 1 and 2. Then you flip it over, you've got 3, 4, 5 and 6, which is seasons 3, 4, 5 and 6. I'm trying to find the other discs now. There it is. So then you've got under here 7, 8, 9, and 10, which is season 7, 8, 9, and 10. Then here 11, 12, 13, and 14, which are Blood Cult Chronicles bonus discs, Grifball, Volume 1 and 2, and Behind the Scenes of Red vs. Blue. If you take some of the discs out, which I'll do now, you can see artwork behind, but it's kind of difficult to see with this camera. If I had one complaint about this box set, it's really big and really flimsy. Like, it could be a lot less design. So, this side you have Agent May from Project Freelancer, and then this side you have Agent Wash from Project Freelancer. Then along the back here, I may as well take all the discs out, you have every character from the Red and Blue Army and every character from Project Freelancer besides Main and Wash, I believe, I can't remember. If I can get the damn discs out, oh yeah. So, seasons 1, 2, and a bit of 3 were filmed in Halo 1. Then the rest of season 3, 4, and 5 were in Halo 2. From then on, it was in Halo 3 up until season 10, I think? Maybe 9, but I'm pretty sure it was just 10 where it was in Reach. However, they went back to 3 for some of the animation stuff, and season 11 was in Halo 4. So then you have this big fold out here of all the Red vs. Blue characters. So I'll go from this side. Here you can see, I know it's a bit reflecty, but you can see all the Project Freelancer characters with Agent Texas in the middle. And then over here you have the characters from the Red and Blue Army. So it's a very big box set. It does cost quite a lot of money. You're looking at the best part of it cost me £100. If you buy direct from RvB, it costs $140, I think. Something like that. It's a lot of money. But especially seeing as all of them are free online, it does seem like a bit of a hefty investment, but if you're a big Red vs. Blue fan, you should get it. Then over here we have Season 11, which was directed by Miles Luna. It was the last thing that came out last year. And inside you simply have a single Blu-ray disc of Season 11. I'm very much looking forward to Season 12, the ending of Season 1. Season 11 was a very short season. A lot of the seasons go on for 20 odd episodes. Season 11 was like 19. It was quite short, but it was a good season. I'm looking forward to where they take it with season 12. In terms of length, if you want to know about length, RvBX goes on for, like, as a total of all 14 bits, it's
roughly 18 hours, 42 minutes. And then season 11, just season 11 itself, is approximately 2 hours. I mean, they're like 3 minute web episodes compiled together to make essentially what is a film per disc. So it's about 2 hours a season you're looking at. Yeah, it's very good. You do have to import from America. So if you're in America, obviously don't worry about it. If you're outside the US, you have to import it from the US. However, they are all region-free Blu-rays. The DVD versions, as far as I know, are also region-free, but you may have to check up on that one. But the Blu-rays definitely are region-free. So, yeah, that is RvBX and RvB Season 11. So yeah, RvBX, RvB Season 11. Both brilliant. You should get them both. And you should watch all of them, at least watch them online, come on now. That's kind of like a segue into my Halo videos, because they kind of loosely tie into the Halo storyline. It is referenced at times, but it is largely its own thing, but it is referenced at times. So that is, you know, like I said, RvBX, RvB Season 11. Thanks for watching, check out my other videos, rate, comment, subscribe, and bye!